Good morning. It's great that you can join the family of St. Mary's Hitchin for this worship video. If you'd like to keep in touch with us and receive our weekly email bulletin, please send an email to the parish office, which is at hitchinparishoffice@btinternet.com. The address should be on your screen now. And if you'd like to donate for the work of the church, which still goes on in these very troublous times, then please do have a look at our parish website. The address is on your screens. There is an online giving portal there. Thank you for your generous donations.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 7. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer that I do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now, if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see it in my members, another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am! Who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
The Gospel reading for Sunday, the 5th of July, is from Matthew, chapter 11. Jesus said, "But to what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another, 'We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn.' For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, 'He has a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, 'Look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Who isn't weary at the moment? Parents are, vicars are, those working from home with back-to-back Zoom meetings are, our health professionals are weary, the hospitality and tourist industry are weary, our teachers are weary. We are all weary. There is so much to be weary about. In the Gospel, we encounter Jesus wishing refreshment upon us, not wanting to weigh us down, but wanting to lighten the load. We spend most of our lives loading ourselves up, don't we? Loading ourselves up with material things, loading ourselves up with anxieties, having the expectations of others placed upon us, so much to load ourselves up with, so many burdens to bear. And as we encounter Jesus, we meet someone who doesn't want to add to our burdens, doesn't want to make life more difficult and tiresome for us, but wants to refresh us and free us. And how desperate so many of us are for refreshment and freedom after such a long period of weariness and constraint. Many of you will be aware that the yoke Jesus talks about has nothing to do with eggs. In fact, it was the wooden bar that was attached to oxen so that they could pull a heavy load. And it's a great image. Jesus doesn't want to weigh you down. He wants you to be able to live a life that's nimble. His yoke was light because he took the over 600 Jewish laws that even the Pharisees and the Sadducees couldn't keep. Those laws that weigh people down. And he made it all very simple indeed. In fact, he distilled all those requirements into two commandments. What were they? Love God, love people. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. So simple, but so hard. There is so much to be bogged down by at the moment, so much to be weary about, so much to beat ourselves up about. Don't. Turn to him who wishes you rest, deep spiritual rest, rest for your body and soul. He doesn't want to make your life harder. He wants to make it better. He wants to make you more nimble. Friends, turn that weariness into a prayer. Rest in God. Love his people. You will feel like something extremely heavy has been lifted. Amen.
Lead me in thy righteousness. May Let us pray. Lord, we yearn to find you and to love you, but we're wrong if we think we can reach you. Our arms are too short, and our eyes too dim, and our hearts too small. To find you, we must let you find us. You are our God, not because you belong to us, but because we belong to you. To choose you, we must realise that we are known and loved in a way that surpasses anything we can imagine. We thank you, living Lord, for your generous love for us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You invite all who are weary to come to you. We pray for all those who feel burdened by whatever oppresses them: sickness, loneliness, fear of the future, fear of death. Help us to see that in your humanity you understand these things, that you hold out your hand to all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, that you offer rest and hope. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our homes and our communities. We thank you for them and for how you touch us through them. Bless all who are struggling financially at this time, and we thank you for the help which is offered. Teach us in our own small way how to reach out to make someone's day a little brighter, be it by our use of time or money or just our willingness to listen and to walk a little way in their shoes. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for all who are ill in hospital or at home, and we pray for those who watch over them. The night can seem so long when we suffer. Be close to people in their fear and pain. In a moment's silence, let us pray for those who are on our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those whose earthly journey has finished and who have come home to you. We ask your blessing on those who mourn their passing and who must daily face the empty place at the table. In a moment of quiet, let us remember them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant, O Lord, that this day may not pass until its full meaning and purpose has penetrated our minds and hearts, to learn more about your loving purposes for us and for all creation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us finish with the words that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I cannot tell my dear. Lord.